So we shall have, for example, the senior vice president for marketing, senior vice president for sales, senior vice president for finance. And now we shall have that of the senior vice presidents. Then we shall structure the whole company into divisions. As you know, we are dealing in a number of things. So all the entertainment companies will fall under the entertainment division. Then we shall have the media division, and then those will be led by chief executives. Then down in the subsidiaries, we shall have managing directors to run the directorates and the subsidiaries. So that means we shall have three layers of management for Afloa Sky Group. It's quite a number of things that inspired me to have such an idea. Personally, I've grown up in the slums of Mbale Town, which has a number of poor people who are living below the poverty line. And so growing up, I attended local primary schools, which has a number of children coming from poor families. So my aim to create a Afloa Sky Group is to see that I bring services closer to the people and to create wealth for my community and to offer charitable works. That's why you see we have come up with ventures or innovations like Visionary Youth International Academy, which is going to help educate the communities and the youths on how to amass wealth and how to better their lives. So empowerment is key on our agenda.
Mr. Mukota, you talked about the partners that you partnered with. Mm. One of them is Joy Essence.
Yeah.
And I want to know more, which other partners do you wish to partner with in the future?
Actually, for our company, it's focusing more on the youth. So, like for Visionary Youth International Academy, we need to partner up with very many schools and organizations that have youth, because we are intending to start up youth centers in at least every municipality within the country. So, as for Elgon Films Limited, we are looking at organizations such as TASO and other major humanitarian organizations, because the films we are doing are education films that tell you.
When I read through your Facebook profile, I found out that you went to Manasa. Can you please tell us a bit about your school life? How was it?
My school life basically has a number of things involved, because at school I did quite a number of things, because as you read through the brochure of Free Hour, you can know that I began this company when I was just only in senior two. So at Manafa, life was good. I was a student leader. I served at the school council, district council. I went up with the national council. So these are some of the things that gave me a stronger foundation and that gave me opportunity to meet up with various people and leaders in our community who inspired me to build up Afro Sky Group. So Manafa is like a home to me, and I have quite a number of things that I can talk about it if you say talk about Manafa.
Can I suppose some few of the
But of course, I have quite a lot, because in Manafa I was in very many positions of student leadership.
Okay. As a dream maker, someone who has established something, people would expect to see some success. And as I look at you, I'm so confident enough to prove that Afewa will go very far. Where do you see it in some 5 years, 10 years to come?
So we took 5 years to build a master plan for our company. And per now, in 2015, we launched our vision 2030 that we are aiming at. And by the time we reach 2030, we shall have quite a number of projects. And Afro Sky Group will have very many subsidiary companies, and it will be run in almost every country in Africa. That's our aim that we are driving at.
Besides, let's say, Afro Sky Group of companies and others, I discovered that you're also a good writer.
Mm.
What inspired you to start writing?
I grew up in a very strict home, so they couldn't. That idea or the love, the passion for books.
You did Silent Voices?
Yeah.
The one of
them. Yeah, that's my production.
Okay. I like, besides Silent Voices, how many other movies have you written?
Actually, there are quite many, because I began writing very early, at a very early age, and for now I think I've written like 40 film projects. And actually now it's going to be a bigger task for Indian Film Limited to be producing and we
I understand that you are doing short films. One of them is The Silent Voices.
Short films to establish our presence in the Ugandan market. That's the goal.
How did you do the audition in this particular
movie? We moved to schools. We distributed flyers and we got applicants. So after getting the applicants, we screened them and we brought out the characters for the film.
How do you intend to advertise the short film once you know the Ugandan movie industry?
Right now in Uganda, we have quite a number of opportunities for filmmakers. Uganda Communications Commission has established the Uganda Film Festival, which is doing very well. And for this year, we intend to submit some short films there for the festivals. And then we are going to be doing community sensitizations. As I told you earlier, we have some schools as our partners. So we are going to be moving to schools, and we showcase our field, discuss about it. Yeah, that's the essence behind that.
As a film producer, writer, and director of the film, I understand there are some good challenges from, let's say, when you're writing to post-production. What are some of these challenges that you faced?
In post-production, or when we are writing words in production, we getting ideas and putting them on paper is something hard. You know, as writers, we need inspiration. So without that, you cannot come up with an idea, and breaking it down into things to come up with a better film. But the biggest challenge I've identified in the film production process is last time when we were in the field shooting Silent Voices, we got quite a number of obstacles as people in the community that we needed to use some of their locations. They could deny us access to these particular locations. So it was very absurd for us. And even some community leaders also could not give us access. They did not know the importance and the impact that film can bring to society. So I really see that the government needs to sensitize much people about the importance of film in this country and how far film can take us.
Yeah, we just talked about the government putting a hand in the film industry. When you compare Nigerian movies, it has created many jobs, and the government has put in some money to fund projects for films, and it has employed quite a number of Nigerians there. So what do you advise about the government? What do you advise the government to do with this issue of film industry in Ghana? Because a number of youth are going hungry, are going jobless because they do not have jobs, and they actually can do well in acting.
What I would like to see the government doing is to begin putting there some initiatives that promote creative art. Because as you know, in schools right now we have seen MDD dying out. And here parents more so emphasize much on taking their students to school to become doctors, to become lawyers.
Hello.
That's what they advise them to do. But they are leaving out the part of creative art. So if the government could come out and really sensitize the people, the parents, about the importance of film, that would be a very greater part for us.
Can only sensitizing be okay? Because we are talking about sensitizing, and only sensitizing people watch films and they
watch films.
But what do you think?
What I say sensitizing is that we have very many people doing filming on the local level, so they also get denied, they are denied the chance to use some of the good locations and some revenue. They will help this motivate the film actors to know that they are appreciated. You know, if you do something and you get that appreciation, there is something it adds on you. And if people appreciate and they are sensitized, they will begin buying Ugandan films. So if they buy, the film producers will be getting some income out of the film. So it will attract more people to join up the industry. And the issue of unemployment amongst the youth will decline.
Now, besides the government, like you, the Afriwas kind of company president, what are you bringing to Ghanaian movie?
Innovation and originality in the stories we tell. If you have watched some of the Ghanaian films, you'll see that they are copying and just pasting the stories that they are doing. So for us, what we bring is originality. We want to do real film that reflects the life of the people of Uganda and the people of our communities. And ahead of that, we are creating up Visionary Youth International Academy. It has subsidiaries, which is going to be teaching these filmmakers.
We're almost coming to an end of this interview. Can you please give an advice to the youth out there? What advice would you give them?
Actually, the what the youths of this country or the youths of Africa should know is that we are living in a fast changing world. You can see that the world is changing much and we are not changing. So if you want to succeed in life, be adjustable and flexible enough. Go out there, read books that will inspire you and motivate you. You take the advantage of the vast information that we have, because right now, any information you need or any person you need to connect to, you can connect with them via the internet. So they can take up that advantage, connect with them. I know that we are living in a changing world, and so they should play by the game.
Okay. I really appreciate you, Mr. Mukada, for having you on the show.
Thank you for hosting me.